Hey guys, in this video we are going to learn how in Cypress we can log in programmatically into our application. And we are also going to take a look at the newly launched cy.session API. So I have created this project just in case you do not have an application against which you can try this out. So you can download this project, okay? Once you download all the code files, okay, you go to your terminal, make sure that you are at the right place, meaning you should be at the location where you see the package.json file. The first command that you have to execute it, you have to say npm install. All right, guys, this will make sure that all the packages that are required for your application are installed. Next thing is we are making use of a backend server built using Express. So you have to start your server first, and for that, guys, you have to run this command. Okay, so we open the terminal and we run this command. This will start your server. If everything works, this is what you're going to see at the end. Okay, so then it says that start your React app. Okay, and for that you have to use this command npm start. So in a new terminal, execute this command. Okay, and the third one, definitely we have to look at the test cases. So let us also start Cypress. So we say npm test this. Let's go back to the documentation. Now, if everything works, right, your application would be launched and have this interface. Now, you see the username and the password. All right. And you have to click on the submit button. When you click on the submit button, then you will be landed onto this home page, and there are two more pages in here, the greet. Okay, you click on go to home and then session demo, and for both you see the URL is changing, and I click on the logout, and that is going to terminate this session. Okay, let's open the developers toolbar and we go to the application. Okay, so guys, currently you see there are no key values present in here. The moment I click on submit, okay, you see this token key is generated in here. All right, great. Now once you're logging into the application, you open a new tab, all right, and you can navigate through the pages of this application. For example, one such page is greet. So I click on greet, and now you see I don't need to log in. Okay, as long as I have a valid session running, you know, I can keep on opening new tab and open new pages. All right, no issues in there. So let me close this. Now, once you click on this logout, what are we doing? Right, we are taking the user back to the login page and we are clearing out all these values. Okay, now how can you log in programmatically? It's very simple. It's using a form. So this is the form. You interact with the fields available on this form, providing the required credential, click on submit. Okay, so in your test case, this is usually what you do. Okay, once you click on the submit button, a session is established, right? So it's always a good practice that you buy in some time, because login process usually takes some time. So what you're doing in here, you're saying that, okay, hey, once you click on this button, you're going to wait until you see this home, okay, in the URL. And of course, I mean, this will give you the 4 seconds window. If you require more time, then accordingly, you have to extend the timeout. All right. And then we are checking that, hey, the logout button should be enabled. That's fine. That's what we do. Okay. The other way possible is using an API, because this application is making use of an API. So in here, you see, we are hitting this particular API. Okay. And then from this API, we are setting this particular hard-coded token. Now, this is a dummy application. You know, in a real world project, what you are going to do is you have the Redis database where you store all these tokens, right? And then you generate unique tokens, you store those into Redis cache, and then ensure that, you know, in subsequent request, user is passing on those relevant tokens, and you match those with the ones that are present in your Redis. Okay, all right, so now what about the configuration? So let us also look at some configuration. So in here you have cypress.env.json file. So API server, this is the URL I'm keeping in here, and then these are the username and password. Okay, great. So in cypress.json, I have kept the base URL, which is the URL of my application. And like I said, we have to use the cy.session API as well, but currently it is in the experimental phase. So to access that, you have to enable this property. All right, and I'm gonna open the custom commands. Okay, so we have the Cypress custom commands, and let's open these side by side. Okay, so this is what you do. You copy this much, okay, put that in here. All right, and you now have the login via UI command available. All right, so I've already created a couple of videos on custom commands, so I hope you know this much. All right, so you copy this much, you put that in here, so you have your command ready. And now what you can do is, guys, this is the test case, and in here now see what are we doing. So we are invoking this command and we are providing the username and password from the Cypress environment.json file, and then we are checking that this should contain home. All right, and then you have got this element that should be enabled, so logout button should be enabled, and then we are visiting the greet page directly. Okay, and we are checking this particular element should be there. So I'm gonna save everything. Let's open the test runner. Fingers crossed. All right, so far so good. This is the old way of doing the login. Okay, now how do we do that using cy.session? Now cy.session, what does it do? So it cache and restore cookies, local storage and session storage in order to reduce the test setup times. Okay, the session API is currently experimental and can be enabled by setting the experimental session support flag to true in Cypress config or by using this at the top of your spec file. So we have chosen to put this in our cypress.json file. Now this is my command cy.session id setup and option. Guys, let's understand each one of these first. So id, okay, so every session will get a unique identifier, which means that you can create multiple sessions for your application. So we have the same code, guys. Okay, let's watch. But then I'm wrapping that in cy.session. And how am I generating the ID? I'm generating the ID by providing the username and password in the array. Why? Because ID can be of type string, array and object. So a unique identifier that will be used to cache and restore a given session. In simple cases, a string value is sufficient. In order to simplify generation of more complex IDs, if you pass an array or object, Cypress will generate an ID for you by deterministically stringifying the value you pass in. Okay, so since the username and password combination will always be unique, so that's why we are using that information for generating the ID. Okay, next one is the setup. So setup is nothing, it's basically the same thing, guys, that we wrote in the first custom command. Yeah, this is how we used to write the login. So you put the same logic in here, but there's a difference in here. So it's always a good practice to also run an assertion. Now this is the extra line that you see in here, which isn't present in here. Now this is an assertion which will give you more time basically. So it is going to wait until it finds this element and then it is in enabled state. Okay, this function is called whenever a session for the given ID has not yet been cached or if it is no longer valid. Okay, after setup runs, Cypress will preserve all cookies, session storage and local storage so that subsequent calls to cy.session with the same ID, guys, okay, will bypass setup and just restore the cache session data. And that is why if you use cy.session, if you update your existing way of login programmatically, it's gonna be faster, okay, because it is being cached. All right, and the last one is an object and it contains log and validate. Log is self-explanatory. Let us look at the validate. So now validate is a function which validates a newly created or restored session. Now validate function is run immediately after the setup function runs and also every time cy.session restores a cache session. This is again important, okay, this always run. The validate function returns false or throws an exception or returns a promise that resolves to false or rejects or contains any failing Cypress command, the session will be considered invalid and setup will be rerun. If validation fails immediately after setup runs, the test will fail. Okay, the other few important things that you have to take care of. So then we go back and say, okay, let me write my validate function. And since I am assuming that I must be logged in, okay, I'm visiting my home page, okay, Alright, as you could see, and I'm saying cy.get, and this button should be enabled. Here's the documentation. Now, this particular command has the following new behavior, okay, that will be the default in the future major update of Cypress. At the beginning of each test, the page is cleared, so internally it would be set to this, and we're gonna see that in a minute. All active session across all domains are cleared. It overrides the cypress.cookies.preserve once and all these things. Setting the session inside setup, because this caches session data immediately after the setup function completes. It's a best practice to assert that the login process has completed at the end of session setup to ensure that setup does not return before the session data is available to be cached. Okay, that's why I said it's important to add some kind of assertion now. Now, asserting session in this way can help simplify your login custom command and reduce the need to conditionally cache sessions. Now, switching session inside test would be very simple, like I said, because it depends upon the ID. So you can pass login like so and then again like so. All right. Now, this is again very important, where to call cy.visit. If you call cy.visit immediately after cy.setup, okay, in your login function or custom command, it will effectively behave the same as a logging function without any session cache, you guys. All right, guys, so this is an important thing that you have to understand when the page and active session data are cleared. So you have the before setup, okay, I've already talked about, we have the setup, then we have this validate, and then once this cy.session is complete, so page would be cleared, current page would be cleared after all of this. Okay, the page is cleared and all active sessions across all domains are cleared automatically when cy.session run. This guarantees consistent behavior whether a session is being created or restored and allow you to switch sessions without first having to explicitly log out. It's very important. Now, how do you design your test cases? So it's very simple. So you have to place your session command in here first in the before each, okay, and then you have to visit the page after session command. It's very important, like I said, because the page is cleared out, okay, so therefore it is mandatory. In here, guys, you don't need to visit the page again, but if you are using cy.session, make sure that you are visiting your page after creating or restoring your session, okay. So in my application, there are multiple pages. Like I said, there is a login page, there is a home page, there is a greet page, and there is a session demo page. Okay, there are four pages. Ideally, you will create, follow the page object model, create separate pages, and therefore, in those cases, you will have this command, and you will say cy.visit, and accordingly, let's say you have to test the greet, so you'll say cy.visit and greet. Okay, but I have, for simplicity purpose, I have created all these cases in here only. I'm gonna comment this out and gonna run my login UI session, and this is what I was saying. So I have to visit this explicitly. Okay, if I don't visit it, I'll show you that first. So I save it and run it. Okay, now you see expected about blank to include home. Okay, this is what we said. So it clear the page, and let us look at the other commands. So a session, new session is created. In here you see the session, you can clear all the sessions if you want, but you see you're creating a new session like so, and then you're clearing the page. Okay, once you clear the page, so after the setup you're clearing the page, after validate also you are clearing the page like you see, and therefore it is important that you visit your page again. Okay, and therefore you do it like so. So if I have just one page, okay, I'm gonna copy this and put it in here, but I'm testing the other cases as well in the same page just for the demo purpose. You know that you have to create the page object model and so on. All right, so I leave it in here, I run it now, and let's see, everything works. Okay, so this time you see restore saved session. All right, and since we are running it for the second time, all right, and it found it in there, and therefore you see all this. All right, everything works. So we visit the home page, and then we moved on to the greet. We did not required to log in. All right, guys, this is how you do it. Now this is about the UI, right? What about the APIs? So let us see that. So for that you say cy.request, you do this, and in then, okay, you set the local storage like your application is doing, you are doing it as well. Okay, the only thing is the data that you are seeing in here might look like a JSON object to you, but it is not. It is a string object, and therefore, whenever you get the response back from your URL and you are setting the local storage, so this is what you use window.localstorage or set item, and then you provide the key, and then we are stringify the response. Okay, so this is how you do it. Now, how do we do that with the cy.session? So this is your login via API session. So you are saying cy.session and you are passing the username and password. This is the same thing that we did, okay, above. So this is your setup method, and then you have this validate. And in here, what are you doing? Since you expect that you already logged in, so you are validating, you're visiting the home page, and you're checking that go back to home page button is enabled. All right, this is what you do. And if you have to use it, it's again very simple. So this is the other test case. So I'm now skipping the normal one, okay, without session. I'm just starting with the session directly. So you see this, you provide in the username and password, and as said earlier as well, mandatory to use cy.visit after your session is created. Okay, so you create, you visit, and then you check for it. So let me save it and check that in here. All right, guys, so you see a new session is created. If you rerun it, you see restored saved session. All right, so this is about, guys, the new cy.session command. I think this is very helpful. This is gonna speed up your execution time. However, you have to be watchful of the fact that now, since this is clearing out the page, you have to use the cy.visit after you invoke the cy.session command. You may need to adjust your existing solution if you want to use this, and you should definitely use this. It's a great feature. So I hope you like this. Thanks for watching.